हेलो 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 हाय हेलो हेलो लक्ष्मी गारू हेलो शरण आर्य देव
हाय सुमा,
हेलो
हाय
हेलो
बेबी।
నేను ఇందాక నుంచి హలో హలో అంటున్నానండి.
ఈ 1 మినిట్ సమ్వేర్ ఆడియో ఇస్ మిస్సింగ్. యా, షల్ వి స్టార్ట్?
2 మినిట్స్ అని మెసేజ్ చేశారు.
వాట్ ఇస్ దిస్? ఐ యామ్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు హియర్ యూ ప్రాపర్లీ.
హి సెడ్ లైక్ హి విల్ జాయిన్ ఇన్ 2 మినిట్స్.
I'm not able to hear your voice. Let me connect with speaker or else. Speaker, ஒண்ணுமே கேட்கலாம். என்ன கண்டதெல்லாம்
எடுத்தல
படிக்க வேண்டியதா?
ஹலோ.
யா, ஐ குட் ஹியர் நவ் ஆஃப்டர் கனெக்டிங் மை ஸ்பீக்கர். Earlier, I couldn't hear anyone's voice. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, 4 members joined.
Hello, hi, good evening.
Hi, good evening.
Hi, Bangalore, good evening.
Hey, hi.
Hi, baby.
Papa, godava chestundandi, baba.
ఓకే ఎందుకు గొడవ చేస్తున్నావు ఓకే టుడే వి ఆర్ మూవింగ్ టువార్డ్స్ డిబి స్కాన్ అల్గోరిథం దిస్ ఇస్ డెన్సిటీ బేస్డ్ స్పేషియల్ క్లస్టరింగ్ ఆఫ్ అప్లికేషన్స్ విత్ నాయిస్ ఇఫ్ పాసిబుల్ యు బై గట్ దిస్ అదర్వైజ్ దర్ ఇస్ నో అదర్ చాయిస్ బట్ వీ కెన్ రిమెంబర్ density is the word throughout the discussion we will be using so this is very easy to remember this d and based spatial clustering what is spatial relationship is the spatial relationship between Bangalore Tamil Nadu and Hyderabad what is the spatial relationship so whenever we try anything visually these are all called spatial relationship so clustering we are c for clustering a for application n for noise so we need to remember these all for whenever expansion is required or somebody asks sometime people will pull down what is the meaning of what is expansion of db scan something like that by that time it is required otherwise it's not required so density based spatial clustering of applications with the noise is the final expansion how it works first let me explain a philosophy behind it then we will go for one animation very fabulous link I have got for demonstrating this db scan algorithm now we need to remember this is the totality of my explanation going to happen for today's session this one pick only going to become most of the time our discussion let us focus is the audio everything is clear for both of you come on dear yeah now see we need to choose a point randomly the point which we are choosing there are two parameters only we need to consider in the db scan algorithm for either for the betterment or for the worst situation one is eps epsilon another one is min points minimum points what it is trying to do is it will choose one of the point as a representative and keeping that point it will start creating a circle how many points you can fit in if you reached this point then whichever the point you have chosen it is treated as core point if it is less than the number of points then it is a border point you may understand may not understand I'll come to the point now don't worry now see what I am doing see first I am having lot of points these are all spread of my point all the data set the entire data set when you start spreading it will have certain pattern that we are going to discuss imagine now we have these many data point in our data set so these are all located like this when I start plotting scatter plot then all my points are located like this whenever it is located like this what I am doing let me fix epsilon practically in the python it is set as 0.1 I don't know why they are setting this whenever you draw a circle what is mandatory to draw a circle or before or after drawing the circle what is the parameter or mathematical terminology we need to be very careful to draw a circle
center and circumference
yeah radius the center point and the radius is enough that radius will talk about your circumference
yes
that's it now we need to choose any one of the point from here randomly among these all scattered point we need to apply this epsilon whatever the epsilon you are setting you can tune this parameter also parameter tuning time you can tune either epsilon or minimum point see we have control or rights to tune in the given python algorithm for the db scan only these two parameter we have control or rights to tune nothing more we have so python aspect I am talking theory aspect it is little bit different so now let me choose this my representative let me put a epsilon then I fix this as my radius means center point then I will be drawing a circle This is very worse situation. Don't worry. Look at the minimum point which I considered are 4. Count all the points. This is 1 point, 2 point, 3 point, 4 point, 5 point, 6, 7, 8 points. Whom I have chosen my center or hero? This was my hero. Now, choosing this person as a hero, fixing this epsilon value, considering this minimum points, I started drawing a circle. That circle covered high density. What is high density? Whenever this 4 and above the points are covered by that circle, then it is called high density. If it is less than 3, sorry, less than 4, it is low density. Since it formed a high density circle, I'm declaring this point as a core point. It becomes a special case. First definition we are coming, core point. Core point identification is very, very primary job of DB scan. Now I come to one more point, one more discussion. Now I am choosing this fellow as my representative. Then I am going for fixing this epsilon value and minimum points, treating this fellow as my representative or center point. I am drawing a circle with the same, it should be uniform, not either bigger, larger. Now look at the scenario. This was my representative. How many points are considered in this circle? 1 point, 2 point, 3 point, 4 point. Exactly it reached this minimum points. Now I declare that this person also a core point. He or she is also my core point now. Now let me move to one more drawing. You adjust whether it is correct or not. I'm bringing a concept. Now let me choose this person as my representative. Let me use a epsilon. Then let me draw one more circle. Luckily, look at 1 point, 2 point, 3 point, 4 point. So I can declare this as a core point. Whenever within a circle I could able to fit the minimum number of points, then that representative point would become core point. Whereas, listen carefully, I'm choosing this as my representative. I'm drawing a circle using the epsilon value. The circle would be like this. Now how many points are there in the circle, newly drawn circle?
Two.
Only two. Do you think that it is meeting minimum points?
No.
No. So that this person is called as border point. That's it. Two definitions I have introduced through this drawing without speaking or explain. Whenever the number of points covered in a circle using this epsilon value, if it falls less than the minimum points which you have set during the algorithm illustration, if it is lesser, even 3 points available also, you are not called as core point. This fellow is called as what? Border point. He is only a border point fellow. Why? Because the number of points available after drawing a circle is less than 4. Naturally, this yellow I induced, otherwise it is 2 only. Whereas, look at this circle, this circle, this circle. In each and every circle, if I consider the epsilon and draw a circle, it is meeting out my expectation, 1, 2, 3, 4. It is a normal circle. Whereas, this is highly dense circle. You are lucky. So many you could fit it in this circle. You are so lucky. That's fine. You are lucky or moderately lucky, doesn't matter. After drawing a circle, if you could cover 4 points in it, then the representative whom you have chosen for drawing a circle with the epsilon value, you will be declaring it as core point. If not, you would be declaring as a border point. So far now, is it clear? Hello, dear.
Yes, yeah.
Now, let us consider this as my representative. I am choosing this fellow as my representative or boss, then I am drawing a circle. You are very poor fellow. No one is sailing with you except this fellow. Not even single person is respecting you. Then this point is called noise or outlier point.
Got it?
Yeah, only 3 points we are introducing the definition. Core point, border point. Now this red color point is said to be outlier or noise point. Is it clear now? What I am speaking, what is the definition I am introducing? Because these three are important throughout the DB scan. Five component. We discussed five component. One is epsilon. I don't know why they kept epsilon. Instead, they would have kept as R radius. The meaning behind it, I don't know. The next is minimum points. These all are your expectation you need to set. Based on these two parameter only, your prediction is going to become better. Then through these three, what you are trying to do is you are trying to find out who are all core point, who are all border point, who are all outlier point, or noise point. This is your prime motto in clustering. Noise point, always it will get isolated. It will not get clustered. These all noise only going to pull down your accuracy of clustering. Whereas border point is partially filled with dense or partially densed, you can say, or low dense, you can say. Whereas core point is highly densed or fully densed. This is what you are trying to learn from this. That's it. Nothing more required to understand. Is it possible to understand?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Easy, she's telling. Oh my God. Then
she knows how to mute and unmute with the button also. That's the problem. She's coming directly and clicking on that.
Yeah, you need to choose a representative. After choosing a representative, using epsilon, you need to draw a circle. This is next step. Then you need to calculate each of the circle filled with, calculate or count. Circle is filled equal to or greater than or equal to minimum points. If that meets, then you are said as core point. Else, it is said as border point. Not either of these two conditions are fit enough, then it is said as third scenario. It is said as outlier or noise. Got it now? That's all algorithm over DB scan. Is it clear now? You are clustering, or your clustering happened, you clustered based on border point and core point. The moment you have more core point, your clustering is clever. The moment your border point is also more, it is much more clever algorithm, clever way of clustering is happening. Except outlier should not be there. If outlier is minimal, your clustering is much better. If outlier is more, your clustering is not good. It could be either core point or it could be either border point. That's it. Now let us go back to the book definition or the material way. Look at here, reachable, not reachable. There are two concepts we need to understand. A point P is a core point. If at least minimum points are within distance epsilon of it, and those points are said to be directly reachable from P. Within a circle, whatever is your representative, all are filled means reachable. Within a circle, easily you can reach. Next, no points are directly reachable from a non-core point. If you have two different core points, then easily you can reach. For example, the earlier diagram, I need to go. This is one circle. This is another circle. This representative is different. It is a core point because it has 4 points, either in the border or circumference or very nearby or within the circle somewhere. then you can declare this fellow as a core point, because minimum point is only 4, we have 5, so this fellow is declared as a core point. Similarly, what they are trying to tell is, it will be moving, yeah. Then these 5 points are directly reachable. Which are all 5 points? Point number 1, point number 2, point number 3, point number 4. All the points whichever exist in a circle, if it is a point or eligible to become a core point, then immediately you can reach all the points. If not, you need to reach, if it becomes border point, you need to catch hold of the adjacent neighborhood core point. Through that person you can navigate. Noisy data or outlier data, never ever you can navigate. If you can't understand this point, reachable, not reachable point of view, please hold on. I will scroll through the slide and you will get it. But here itself I'm introducing. Q is reachable, P is reachable. If you have a core point, something like that we are talking, no? We will look at. Now look at this core point they are declaring. All the red colored points are core point. If you consider any circle, see this is a circle. Within that you have 4 points. So that it became core point. Look at yet another circle, this circle. Within that you have 5 points. So that it is declared as core point. Look at that this circle. It has 4 points. So that this circle also having core point. Anywhere all the red colored dots are core point. This is noisy point, because in this epsilon circumference, you don't get any other point except this fellow sitting isolated, living alone. So that it is said to be noise. Border point is, look at this yellow color circle or yellow color dot. This is the representative. There are 2 dots are occurred within the circle. So that it is less than the minimum points, it is set as the border point. Look at this yellow color circle. This point is my representative. After drawing the circle, I could accommodate only 2 points, low density. So that it is also less than minimum point, so that I declare this circle or this representative as my border point, this representative is my border point, this representative is my noise point, all the red colors are my core point. Could you get my point now? Is that clear, guys?
Ma'am, can you please repeat that last 1 minute, ma'am?
What I said, definitely I'm telling now verbally. Earlier visually I was telling, now verbally I'm trying to tell. Now,
okay.
Listen a little bit carefully. I'm choosing this fellow, this red fellow as my representative. Using this epsilon value, I'm drawing the circle. Carefully watch how I am navigating. This is my circle. After drawing a circle, I'm calculating how many points are inside, the density of the points. There are 4 points sitting inside my circle. Because of meeting this guideline, minimum points equal to 4, I have written algorithm here itself, no? You were there?
Yes.
That only visually we are discussing. Now, 4 points are accommodated in a circle. This person is promoted or declared as core point, because I have chosen this person as a leader or representative or hero of the circle. He could able to bring 4 people into the circle. He invited, he is capable of inviting 4 people. So I'm promoting this fellow as my core point. Got the idea?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, look at this. I'm treating this my representative. I'm drawing the circle. Look at carefully. This is my circle. In this circle, there are 5 points are represented. It is much more than the minimum points what I require. So this person also promoted a core point. Now look at any red point. Keep that red point as a representative and look at the circle. See, this is my representative. I'm drawing this circle. Within this circle, if I keep this fellow as a representative, there are 4 members are sitting together. So I'm promoting this person also a core point. Again, I'm calling this person as my hero. Keeping this person as my hero, I'm drawing a line, circle. See, look at this circle. within the circle, 5 points are there. So I'm promoting this fellow as a core point. Again, look at, I'm keeping this person as a representative or hero. Which circle would be fit enough for this person? Look at the center of the point. This is a circle made up of keeping this fellow as my hero. If you look at this circle, there are 4 points are accommodated. It is satisfying my condition. So I'm declaring this fellow also a core point. So whenever you are choosing a representative, using that representative, you need to draw a circle based on the set epsilon value. After drawing the circle, you need to calculate the availability of points both on the circumference as well as inside the circle. If it happens to become equal to or greater than the minimum points, you need to declare that as a core point. If it is less than, you need to declare as a border point. Look at this yellow person. He is my representative. So I'm using this fellow. I started drawing the circle. How many are I could accommodate? Only 2 member. So he is a poor fellow. So I'm declaring this person as a border point. Whereas I'm keeping this fellow as my representative. I'm drawing the circle. No one is bothering, not even single vote. So that I'm declaring this person as my outlier or noise. That's it. So this is the base or foundation for DBSCAN. Is it clear? Clear for you now? There are three. Yeah, using epsilon and using minimum points, you will be finding out. Your primary duty is to find out how many core points are there in your data set, how many border points, how many noise points are there in your data set. After identifying all the 3 points, you are succeeded the accuracy of clustering based on only core and border point. The person who is pulling you going to be only the noise point or outlier. Otherwise, this fellow is going to become your enemy for the accuracy point of view. These two are going to become your friend. Then core to core easily you can connect, but border to core never ever you can reach. Whereas core to border you can reach. How you can reach is through core point. Through core point only you can reach. So that point we will discuss little bit later in this slide. Is this okay now? Up to this only 5 concept you need to be thorough. Epsilon, minimum point, core point, border, noise, drawing a circle. After drawing the circle, number of points accommodated in the circle seems to be equal to or greater than the minimum point, you need to declare that representative as core. If it happens to be lesser than the minimum points, then you need to declare it as a border. When you need to declare a noise is, not even single person is ready to make a friendship with that fellow. He is getting isolated. That person is declared as noisy or outlier. That's it. Nothing more you need to learn from this. Now, when to use DBSCAN is the question. Whenever the points or data points are clustered in this pattern, dense pattern. Look at when we discussed k-means clustering, you would be having a centroid, then all other fellow will be sitting very nearby. Very nearby, these fellows will come and sit, make friendship. Then this becomes one cluster. Whenever it takes this kind of pattern, non-linear pattern, k means clustering won't help. This is called very non-linear pattern or different pattern or shaped pattern. The better word is shapeful pattern or shaped pattern. Particular shape, if it takes, k means will not work out. That is the time you need to depend on DBSCAN. That is your fate. Is it clear now? Why we are discussing DBSCAN is if the data points are going to become this kind of pattern, definitely your k-means will not help you. Now let us come back from the beginning with verbal. Clusters are dense region. When you will declare as a cluster is dense region. Look at DBSCAN. This is one pattern. Through DBSCAN, you can easily scan this fellow. You can form this as a cluster. This is another cluster. This is another cluster. These fellows are very poor fellow, could not combine with anyone. So all these black circles are outliers. Yellow, red, blue. Finally, it forms a cluster. So these are all declared as a cluster. This is possible with the DB scan. So all the arbitrary shape, I said na, any kind of shape, it discovers. That is the beauty of DB scan. Very different shape. It could be even, it could do smiley shape. I will show you one fun data. It will find out if your data is spreader like a smiley, it finds out. Smiley data. If your data distribution spreader like smiley, DB scan will do better. K means cannot even work for this. K means. Not at all possible for K means to work on this kind of data. Or poor performance, that's it. Nothing more. Not at all, we can't say poor performance. Now let us come back. Initial step. What is said to be neighborhood? If any, the point, distance between any point, your representative point is P, the chosen point is Q, representative and the chosen point, the distance is less than epsilon, then they both are called as neighborhood. When you will say neighborhood at your circumstances, whomever lives in 1 minute of stepping out of your home or within 2 minutes, if you could able to meet anyone fellow around you, they are all your neighborhood. You can't say myself as your neighborhood. You need to travel a lot. Even Suma and me are living in the same city, but it would take 2 hours journey for meeting each other. So never I can say we both are neighborhood. Could you get my point? Whenever the distance, how to calculate the distance is your next question. The distance can be calculated either using or whatever the distance measure we discussed earlier. Euclidean distance. Euclidean. Something spelling. Okay. Manhattan distance. So many are there. Minkowski. Last class we discussed this all. Minkowski distance. Taxi cab. There are so many distance. These, any one of the distance you can use. That is your choice. Your problem. That is not a matter. We need to choose one representative before drawing the circle. After drawing the circle, whomever comes and fits in the circle, we need to find out the distance between the representative. My representative is P. This fellow is P. This fellow is Q. If the distance between these two people are less than the epsilon, this is called my epsilon. It is less than or equal to. Even circumference also I said, no, a point can sit on the circumference. If that equation is matched, you are declared as a epsilon neighborhood. Now these two are called, this P and Q are said as neighborhood persons. That's it. It's very easiest algorithm. Nothing to worry of this. Now when you will say high density, if the number of minimum points are accommodated in a circle should be greater than or equal to 4. Otherwise it is called as low density. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now again, one more example. See, core border outlier, core point. For this, minimum points are 5 they are fixing. Epsilon they are fixing 1 unit. So look at, let us calculate. This is the representative. Then it draws a circle. Within the circle, how many points including the representative? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6. 3 or 5 are sitting on the circumference. Not a matter. So because of these 6 points are accommodated in this circle, this fellow is declared as a core point. Whereas I'm choosing this fellow as my representative and I'm drawing a circle, I could accommodate only 2 points. It is less than 5. So I'm declaring as a border. Whereas outlier, this fellow couldn't even form any one of the person, not even one more additional person. He is sitting isolated alone, so that he is declared as outlier. That's it. Nothing more we will be learning through this. Is that okay? Again, definitions are given. See, there I didn't give definition, only picture. Given epsilon minimum points, categorize the objects into three exclusive groups. Core point, border point, noise point. Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Let us look at this. See, if you do original points after DB scan, it does. All the green color are set as core point. All the blue color are set as border point. All the outliers are set as red point. Whereas K-means algorithm does like this. K means very tedious to interpret. Can you able to interpret anything? All the clusters, whether it is formed cluster or not, we cannot even identify. Although the points are sitting adjacently, algorithm, how it is identifying, you can't able to notice. Can you able to sensitize what I am trying to tell? See, there is no distinction between outlier or cluster. Really, clusters are formed through your algorithm. You can't identify. This is the original points seating arrangement. Originally, these fellows are sitting like this. But whether your eyes can able to detect the groups or gangs in the people, that cannot be predicted. Whereas, see, clearly the DB scan recognizes easily or separately distinguished way who are all my core point, who are all my border point, who are all my outliers, very clearly telling. So looking at this, we can easily identify clustering happened or not, how it had happened. And another interesting point is any kind of shape. Here you have T shape, here you have a rectangle shape, here you have something like we have this letter in Tamil, we used to say pa, this shape, and it is ulta pa. So this one, another shape, and this is like a peacock feather, this is another shape. All the shapes you can find out using DB scan algorithm. That is the beauty of DB scan. Now let us move further. See, this slide also you can go through, nothing required. Where I want to emphasize is here. Look at, minimum points are 7. In this minimum point, P is a border point, Q is a core point, because it has 7. See, count it, 8. Count P1 representative, count more than 7. Keeping P2 as a representative, count all the dots in the circle. Keeping P as a representative, count all the dots in a circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, I am failed. So, using P, you can't travel anywhere, you can't reach any of the neighbor, you can't meet anybody. Whereas using Q, you can meet P1, using P1, you can meet P2, using P2, you can meet P. Because of this interconnectivity, from Q, you can meet P easily. Vice versa is not possible. That is the message they are conveying. Density reachable directly or indirectly. You can directly reach P from P2. You can indirectly reach P from P1 via P2. Got it? I used to say one story. That story, I don't know whether I'm right or not. Hello is the word how it is invented. There is no English dictionary will be explaining about hello. Hello, I am telling na when I call.
Yes, ma'am.
Graham Bell, when he invented phone, what he used to say is direct connection switching is happening in the hub recent days. Those days he didn't invent that hub or contact switching and all. What he used to do is he will be connecting direct line to his neighborhood person. Neighborhood person, another fellow in his nearby person, he will connect. Then what he used to do, it seems, he will make a call. Hello, Grish. Allow me to talk with Suma. I will tell, it seems. Then you will give a connection to her. After the contact switching, if you do only, whatever I'm speaking, she can able to hear. Suppose fourth person is involved, then I will be telling to again calling Suma, connect with your baby, I want to talk to her, allow me to talk to your baby a little. Then she will be connecting that line with another context. That is the way allo became hello like that. I heard the story. It is like that. I am calling. I am the queue. I am calling Girish. Allow me to talk to Suma. I am calling Suma. Allow me to talk to your baby. Like this.
Ma'am, let's consider a scenario here.
Which scenario?
We are traveling from Q to P1, P1 to P2, then we are trying to kind of travel from P to P, right?
Yeah.
In that scenario, that P as a core, the P2 as a core, right? Then
yeah. P is not a core, it is a border.
The border, not P2 as a core, right? In that, if we move slightly ahead, if you make another point as a P2, then we can capture P inside the circle, right?
Yeah, that is called hypertuning parameter.
Okay.
So that which algorithm you are using, how you are picking, what way you are trying to connect, how you are deciding, that all matters again.
Okay.
Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. That are all the tricks you captured. I was telling fixing epsilon and fixing minimum points. This is also another trick. How you fix number of minimum points, how you fix epsilon is a primary consideration. To whom you choose a representative is another consideration. Exactly, you reach that point. Before even I articulated, you reached it. Correct. Now, your success of game is dependent on primarily epsilon. Secondary, number of points, minimum point we know to tell, number of points also we can tell. Number of points, as you said, whom we choose as a representative. That's it. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now let's move. Sorry, save. Why I saved? Not at all record. 1 minute. DB scan, that all simple explanation, one algorithm. I have written this algorithm only in our own simplest way. You can interpret, nothing more to talk about it. Now, how they are doing is based on trials. You need to plot a graph and how you are increasing the neighborhood density. Depending upon it, you can declare. You need to do a simulation. Based on the simulation only, you can decide what is your epsilon and what is your minimum points. So trial and error, that's what hyperparameter tuning, we need to keep on changing epsilon and making min as a fixed, making min as a changeable parameter, keeping epsilon as a fixed, or keeping both as a changeable parameter, like that you need to do trial and error, then chill out the index value we need to calculate. That will give you which one is working better. That's it. Now let us move to another slide. Is this okay now?
No.
See, original point, K means won't work out. This DB scan will work out to identify all the patterns. This we have seen.
Ma'am,
now,
if you interpret these two diagrams here, see, if we are looking for a preciseness based on the distance, there's nothing more, right?
No, ma, you can't identify, it won't even make a color, it won't even do anything, it is original position itself is like that, not after clustering.
Correct, that is what, when you talk about k-means, the first one is considered as a k-means here.
Yeah, exactly, original k-means both same.
In that, you know, we can't find who is densely clustered, who is outlier, who is border.
If you are centroid here, these all fellow are treated as your neighborhood.
Exactly. So the basic idea is what? Inside clustering, we are still making the data and the prediction is precised in this DB scan, correct?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. Now let us move to further. See, it works for noise, it works for shapes, it works for sizes. In the canine clustering, there is no concept called noise. Whatever is left out and fit, not able to accommodate within the cluster, all are treated as noise. That's it. Whereas here, it has very clear distinction for noise representation. Now, when DB scan does not work well, although we are blaming K-means and appreciating DB scan, it has also its own debate. None of the algorithm is super duper. That is why the data science is troubling us. So many algorithms, so many models, that's why we are freaking out. Now, cannot handle varying density. See, all of a sudden, low density, medium density, and little bit high density, thick density. See, look at any city, if you go to Majestic, it will look like this. You can't even walk without hitting any fellow. If you come to outskirts, it will be like this. If these kind of pattern exist in your data scattering, what is the scattering is, you need to just throw the data. You need to plot through scatter plot. Whenever this kind of pattern takes low to high density, then it won't work well. Look at here, there is no high density. It is a kind of pattern. Pattern, it works very well. But it won't work with low and high density. It is very tough for forming a cluster. Then you would be missing out a lot of points into outlier category. That is the message or takeaway. Now, summarization. It is great at separating clusters of high density versus clusters of low density within a given data set. It is great with handling outliers within the data set. Disadvantage is varying density available, then it is very tough. Highest, low, then food. So many diversified data set is available, it's very tough. Next, dimensions are your dimension is too high. Now, dimension means not the row. Always we should be very careful. The moment I am talking about dimension, it typically represents number of columns, attributes, A1 to AN. If your number of dimensions are too much, then it won't withstand, it won't work well. That is a message. So take away, this is over. Now let us move to one beautiful, one animation link. You will be more crazy, I guess. I don't know, I can't assure. Yeah. Come here. See. Look at this is the index page. Look at uniform point based on the scattering. How this fellow, I was going mad after going through this website. Even this website, I got it by exactly 6:45. After this website only, I texted that 7:30. Gaussian mixture, smiley face, pimpled smiley, packed circle, density bar, DB scan rings, example A. These are all typical representation of data scattering. Let us see one thing. This is DB scan clustering. It has this. Now let me click one by one. Let me use smiley. This is what I did first. Let me click this smiley. Yeah. This is called smiley. Can you look at the data pattern? See how beautiful it is. Look at this is your outer. Using this website only, I came to know this smiley. When I was doing the data, I was telling, this is eye, this is eye, this is your mouth. Smiley pattern. Now look at, I am fixing epsilon and minimum point, you can't change it. Epsilon is 1, minimum points are 4. Look at carefully how it is forming the DB scan. Start. How nice it is, see?
No, ma'am. No, I won't laugh. I'm abused.
See, minimum point I'm changing. Yeah, at the epsilon also I can change. Look at, see, I'm changing. The moment I changed it, it became green color.
Right, looking for another radius, no?
Yeah, yeah. Because it is another pattern, it would give you in different color. It detects and does. Snai has come. DV scare. Ayya. Yeah. Now, let us take one more packed circle or Gaussian mixer. This is called Gaussian mixture of data. For this, you can adjust epsilon, increase epsilon, increase minimum point, go. Whichever it could not cover, these are all outliers. See, two outliers you got. It won't tell you border point, core point. It's all considered in this simulation. Only outliers are signified to you, because outliers only pulling your accuracy in the algorithm DB scan. So it is detecting and showing how many outliers at the end. So you can play like a kid whenever you are free.
I'm just I'm just amused saying that how much effort the people are putting in to make it understand to others.
Yeah, definitely. Awesome. At least I am going through picking, hunting, and I will be cooking up all the material. That's it. But how passionate they are to write algorithm, and that is a spirit of teaching meeting. And I can say Westerners will do a lot, because their packages, the appreciation are more. And sometimes these are all shown as a project, students project, M.Tech level, B.Tech level. That kind of projects are appreciated in the Western community, not in India.
Yeah, ma'am, I know.
Now let us move to coding part. By another 5-10 minutes, I will be completing the coding part, so that we can... where is my... Arvind. Already we have seen. Anyway, if you wish, we can walk through. These are all the plots. Most of the time, we are looking at the visual, so that these all visual plots are brought. If possible, I will enhance this notebook itself a little bit more. Then I will send you. I have to send you name base. I haven't done it. Maybe tomorrow I'll be sending all. Okay. Next, read the file, info, describe. These all very fundamental level. Then we are calculating the mean, mean income of female, mean income of male, that we have discussed yesterday. Then heat map, correlation between each and every variable. Then gender wise, group by. If you do group by gender wise also, it is a look at this cluster age, more or less same. Annual income, more or less same. Spending nature, score, more or less same. So there is no great difference in it. Visualization, again, different way we are trying to understand, nothing more. Then what we are doing, count plot, gender-wise we are doing counter, how many male are there, how many female are there. Female are more than male, that is only inference. Then distance plot. Nothing to worry of this all. Now directly where we need to move. Dendrogram plot. This is hierarchical clustering. Actually tomorrow I will be touching upon the theory. Then I will come to this also. Linkage concept, dendrogram. Hierarchical clustering coding is only this much. The earlier also what I scroll through, that is also where the exact hierarchical clustering is happening is only this code. Tomorrow I will be talking about hierarchical clustering. This is for the theory I need to talk later. So tomorrow we will move. So let us skip. Now k-means clustering. This is what exactly your k-means clustering. Nothing more you are doing. So with this k-means clustering, you are finding k-means inertia elbow method. To fix the number of clusters, you are going to fix the number of clusters 5. Because this elbow is turned at this point. So your cluster would be 5. That is why number of clusters 5. We need to remember, how do you find out the number of clusters using in k-means? Means I will use elbow method. Elbow method will guide me to fix the number of k-means clusters. So that we should remember all the time. Then these are all the parameters: maximum inertia, number of initial point. If you go through this random state equal to 0, if you keep 1, 2 to be different. So kindly go through this whenever you are applying on your real-time work. Understand everything. These are all academic projects or for explanation. So we can discuss anything. Then what we are trying to do? Visualizing all the clusters. Just we are putting a visual plot. See, nowhere outlier are there. All those left out points are surrounded and attached with that. It is all one family. See, wherever the red is going, it is attached to that one family. So outliers you cannot even make out. It won't withstand for outlier. That is one of the drawback of k-means. Got the idea now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Advantage, these are DB scan clustering we are coming. For that, sklearn.cluster import DB scan. Similarly, we used k-means. Look at, we use the sklearn.cluster import k-means. If it is hierarchical, similarly, that's it, nothing more. Then your major function after importing, which you are using, is k-means and k-fit. This is variable. If the variable can be anything, your name also, then fit. These two are the only function really helps us. This is the line helps to import the necessary information record for our prediction. Then moving to DB scan clustering. See, who is your hero? Epsilon minimum sample. If you put it in a loop, it would be different. See, let us scroll through quickly. Shellout variable minus 0.19 it has come. If you change minimum sample as 5, or epsilon if you reduce, it may improve also. You need to try it out. So you can these two in a loop, then in your DB you need to, for every change you need to fit the DB scan. You need to calculate shellouts optimum. Zero means overlapping industry is happening. See, you got, it is not at all worst, not at all best, intermediate. Minus 0.1 only you got, not minus 1 you got. So this is considerably better prediction or better clustering happened in our case. This is how shellout score. Yesterday I didn't tell. Now it is mandatory for me to talk whenever DB scan. Now look at, we are fitting model dot labels. How many labels, how many clusters are formed? If you want to know, you can use this code. Then through this you will come to know. This code will give you the number of clusters you have. So say n cluster, this will give you number of clusters, n clusters. Then this will give you matrices. The matrices to find out the accuracy of DB scan is shellout score. This 4, 0, minus 1, 1. If you are towards minus 1, you are into worst. The material I had given in the, it is there in the k-means material itself. No need to worry. The shellout score I have included in the k-means lesson. Tomorrow, k-means, DB scan, and anyways, theory material, or now it's theory material I'll dispatch. More to corona, I want to hold for tomorrow's much more modification I wanted to do. That's it. K-means matrix 0.55. You can see shellout, using shellout. 0.5 is what? You can't appreciate this also. It is not even 1 also. So if you are getting 1, you are much better. If you are getting minus 1, you are very poor. If you are getting 0, overlap clusters are there. Too much of overlapping is there. So this is also intermediate. It fits somewhere here. This is also intermediate. It fits somewhere here. So nature of the clustering technique is too good. Both of the clustering techniques are intermediary performance. Neither it is plus 1 nor it is minus 1. Could you get that now what I'm speaking?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Shiloud score is the common way of comparing two different cluster scores. So this I tried for both today, K-means and DB scan. Few more idea I got it. I wanted to do much more. Then the same notebook I will use it for hierarchical. I'll use it for DB scan. I use it for K-means all together. Consolidation. Tomorrow I wanted to revisit. That's it.
Okay.
Yeah. Anything else? Any questions, Suma? Suma is mute, I think so. Yeah, yeah. Unnara chepandi.
I will recap it tomorrow morning.
Video choose kondi.
Yeah, sure, definitely.
Yeah. I think so. Tomorrow I will be winding up the session. I request Arvind Infotech to give you a video mode of conversation tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll be completing hierarchical clustering and regularization. If you want tomorrow or day after tomorrow, any one day, that day we would be winding up. Our the formal sessions are over, then later on the informal connectivity always there. That is for sure. We have come to a parallel celebration level. Why Girish was smiling, laughing?
No, I'm just thinking something. I'm sorry.
Something is different, Girish. Don't worry. No coronavirus effect.
I mean, literally, I got more scared because of Suma, ma'am, this day. So much information on WhatsApp.
Simply, they are making people to become panic. Yeah, irritating. Whenever I dial the phone also.
Yeah, actually, it is happening because two of my friends are working in IT in Whitefield. Mm-hmm. They keep on posting. So that's the same thing is I'm forwarding.
Don't read, please. I say you. Whenever negative thought comes, don't read, don't look at, don't put your effort and all. It's waste of time.
No, but it's true, ma'am. But the whatever she told is correct. There is a panic situation here. You know, they declared. Yeah.
Simply, they are attacking our mind. It's like a virus now.
Actually, you are talking about virus only, ma'am.
Mind virus they are injecting. Not even physiology virus. Psychology virus they are injecting. Than even physiology. That spreads very slowly, whereas mind virus they are spreading very fast. Every
yeah, just because of the social media, actually.
Yeah, not only social media. See, look at WhatsApp video calls also. That corona sneezing they are putting. I horrible. I couldn't even.
One of my friend prepared the Power BI report on coronavirus.
Then
maybe his manager is not giving work to him over.
Man, whomever I am calling, dialing coronavirus advertisement. I am dying in the past 2-3 days.
Ma'am, you just press ash.
Yeah, that today only one message had come. I didn't try it. Ash. Then people are putting ringtone. So I have one close student. We used to talk every day. So he had put a ringtone. I was surprised for you alone. Why it is not coming? That sneezing and all. I said no. I have put ringtone, ma'am.
No.
So these are
only Airtel customers. Coming Airtel customers, not for any another operator. Coming Airtel customers only particular numbers.
G83 ringtone for other Airtel and all. We may need to pay.
That's why I'm saying to Girish also, it's only digitalized favor party, not gathering.
Digital favor party we can do. That is tomorrow we are going to see each other. No, that is a farewell party.
No, Lakshmi garu, if you want to give pest there, he has to come down to Hyderabad because we both are in the same place.
Yeah,
right?
So majority clustered at now Hyderabad.
He will not fly. Definitely he will not fly to Hyderabad now.
Representative point, all the core point, all the cluster, the entire cluster is available at Hyderabad.
Yeah.
You guys treating me as outlier?
Yeah, exactly.
See, will you come down to Hyderabad right now? Tell me. This situation.
Why not? You just stop coronavirus there for sure. And come. Sure, guys. I'll meet you someday.
In Hyderabad, in this.
Which is your native?
So definitely most welcome.
Bangalore, ma.
Bangalore, Karnataka. Is your native?
Yeah, ma'am. Bangalore.
So you are Karnataka?
Yes, I'm a Karnataka.
Okay, okay. I am Tamilian. Baruthe, Thakas. Naan Mysore alli MTech
odidini. Oh, illi yav college?
University of Mysore alli.
Oh, okay, 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 okay. Super.
Aamele Bangalore alli 1 year work maadta idini. Adi Games Institute of Higher Education, Jalali Cross, Peenya. Past 4 years illi idiyane, Hyderabad. Bangalore alli Hyderabad shift aidini. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಚೆನ್ನಾಗ್ ಬರಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ಲೇ 4 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ವಿತ್ ಕನ್ನಡ. ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ನೌ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಟ್ರಬಲ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್.
ದಟ್ಸ್ ಫೈನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ತೆಲುಗು ಯು ಗೈಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಹ್ಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲರ್ನ್ ದಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಐ ಅಪ್ರಿಷಿಯೇಟ್ ದಟ್.
ನೋ ನೋ ನೋ. ಯಾ, ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್? ಕನ್ನಡ.
ಯೆಸ್.
Yeah, yeah. Because I was put up in the university hostel, no? That their Kannada medium students are there. Literally, they will study Kannada literature. Those people cannot even articulate one sentence or maybe fluent. Then we are forced to learn Kannada. That is the way.
Yes. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe if at all they would have stayed in Bangalore, it become Ulta, I guess.
Yeah, that is true. Then when I was there in Bangalore for 1 year, I was picking up a little bit better. I started speaking, I started using a lot of vocabulary. Then after relocating to Hyderabad, gone case.
Yeah, you see, more into Telugu now, that's why.
Yeah, more into Telugu each day.
You guys do visit Bangalore frequently?
I had been February 1st week. The moment I started handling class 5 sessions or 3-4 sessions, I had given long vacation. That 4-5 days, I said, no, I'm out of station. I was in Bangalore only.
Ma'am, you didn't inform.
That time, how I know? None of the detail I know. You know one thing, even I informed the Kannan sir, he also didn't bother. Nobody bothered. Actually, his one of the working partner is was my colleague in the earlier institution. He was director. I was working there in that college.
Okay, okay.
So even informing them also, they didn't even bother. They didn't even call or informed anything.
Then okay, next time when you are planning to come, ma'am?
Next time, probably April end or May 1st week, definitely I would be there. So many relatives are there.
Okay.
I'd be visiting them, definitely.
Please buzz me off, man. You know, let's meet.
Definitely, definitely. Because only 35 more or 45 days only to go, no? I'll be there.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure. Hi, baby. Are you coming to Bangalore or coming to Hyderabad?
No, let she be there, ma'am. We don't want to disturb with Corona.
You don't think of that, yaar. I don't know. You both are attacked by that virus mentally.
Ma'am, you just entered this IT sales. No, I call it them. I don't call them as IT companies. Now it become a sales. When you entering, you have to pour that sanitizer. Coming out, put sanitizer. Touch, put sanitizer. You can't use lift. You can't use, you know, you can't sneeze. You can't cough. It's kind of a drama. It's all happening in our company.
That's what a corporate side only, it's becoming so much issue, I think so.
Yeah, because the people need to travel across, right? That's why.
They are only globalized, na, what we can do.
And whomever they found out corona positive, all they came from other overseas countries.
Okay.
That is the biggest problem.
See, one fellow LinkedIn I'm opening, dear HR, I'm suffering from coronavirus and request you to grant me paid leave for 20 days. Otherwise, I'll come to office, dot, dot, dot. Simply, they're fun.
No, there was an actually joke spreading across in, you know, in over WhatsApp. Before I used to ask my manager for a leave, he used to cough by saying, why, when, why, where are you going? Now, the moment I cough, he'll only ask me to go out, take leave. That case now.
Really, I don't know what's happening out. I'm keeping myself busy with the two inspections are there within this month. So I'm totally packed up. No time to cook also. Sometime I'm buying outside. Sometime I'm requesting my husband to prepare.
Hey,
going on.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bootinava.
Maybe she got paid out.
Yeah, they have put mute, I think. Yeah. Hello, Bootinava. Pappu tinnava, annam tinnava, tindi aita, oota aita.
She's so crazy girl. She wants chocolate, ice cream. I stopped everything due to this. Now that's why she was so angry on me. I stopped mobile, laptop, ice cream, chocolate, chips. Like, she's fighting us. Last 10 days, we were both fighting.
They are jealous of mother. Why she alone uses all the gadgets? She is owning everything. Why not me?
Now she's asking to paint it in lap.
Okay,
guys,
take care.
Let's sign
off
today.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Yeah, bye-bye. Sign off.
Yeah.
Good night.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye, Bhutinu. Bye.
Nice.
Good night.
Bye bye. Good night. Bhaga Bhutino. Bye.